Hey everyone, Alessandro here, another video, and if you have been following me, one of the things that I keep saying is that numbers don't lie, but they're so easy to misrepresent. And I thought of shooting this video because this is the exact representation of what I just said. Numbers don't lie, but they're so easy to misrepresent. So now let's cut to the chase and let's just see the example that I prepared. Now, this is a very relatively easy report based on the booking window, so the time that elapses between the booking date and the arrival date. Now you see a bunch of numbers, a little bit of a legend. It might sound complicated, but it's very easy. Now on the left you have the dimension, which is what I call the booking window range. Essentially is, so for example, 1 to 5, meaning all those searches conducted 1 up to 5 days prior the selected arrival date. Now if you look at this report without any kind of filter, so in the given period we see that for example 1 to 5 is performing relatively good, but definitely 6 to 10. So all those searches conducted between 6 and 10 days prior the selected arrival date, that is actually outperforming everything else, 15%, more than 15%. Now, for example, let's just assume that I'm gonna switch to mobile device only. And as you can see, 6 to 10 is totally underperforming. Now, this is something that I keep seeing quite on a regular basis. And when it's something like this, it's definitely for sure something that is happening on a distribution level. In other words, OTAs, bidding a cheaper deal, simple as that. So this is exactly why I meant that numbers don't lie, but they're very easy to misrepresent. Because if I go back and select all devices, so including desktop and tablet, I would assume that all those searches conducted 6 up to 10 days prior to the selected arrival date, well, that's perfectly fine. But mobile device is something that tells me totally wrong. Totally different. Now, I'm gonna use this data and these specific two filters, meaning mobile devices and searches conducted 6 up to 10 days prior to the selected arrival date. In a moment, I'm gonna share to my screen. I'm gonna make you see my screen, my mobile screen, because I want you to look at what's exactly happening. And I'm gonna show you exactly what users potentially see depending on these two filters. So mobile device and booking window 6 up to 10 days prior to the selected arrival date. So I'll see you in a moment. I was thinking of shooting a separate video just for my mobile, recording my mobile screen, but actually I realized it was a little bit too much of a mess. So I decided to just collect a few screenshots and combine them in a couple of slides. Now, we're talking about booking window and especially mobile. When it comes to low performance on mobile devices, there is actually one thing that I usually suggest everyone doing. Expedia, Ctrip, and Agoda, go check them. Because specifically the mobile apps as opposed to the mobile sites. Now, Expedia, Ctrip, and Agoda are three out of the four biggest OTAs in the market, globally speaking. The fourth is Booking.com. However, Booking.com does barely collect the payment, meaning that customers do not pay upfront, but they pay you upon check-in or check-out. Whilst Expedia, Ctrip, and Agoda, they do collect the payment, so essentially users pay them upfront at the time of booking, and therefore they have high possibilities to playing around with their own margins by undercutting your rates. The second thing, like I said before, mobile apps as opposed to mobile sites. Mobile sites do have different prices as opposed to mobile apps. And the last thing is that the reason why they use mobile apps essentially because they want to lock prospects in and leverage their loyalty program. And this is, we're going to see it in a second, the difference between mobile sites and mobile apps. All right, so now let's jump into the example. Booking window 6 up to 10 days, first Ctrip. This is the search on the mobile site of Ctrip, and I landed on this page after having a very first search on Google. And you see the prices in Thai baht. You see on the very bottom 5,888, simply because I'm in Thailand. But besides the value, you see on top an interesting thing that Ctrip is already offering a very strong call to action. Essentially, they're offering me to download the application so that I likely going to find the better deals. The call to action of download loading the app there on top is pretty typical. I mean, across all industry, that's beyond the point, but it's already quite a powerful call to action. So I downloaded the app and this is the price. I simply made the exact same search, but this time through the mobile application, the price was totally different. You see also the look and feel is slightly different, but you see the dates, February 3rd for 2 nights, 2 adults, but essentially the price is already cheaper. And again, there is another call to action, which is a sort of, I don't know, I would say tripwire offer, but essentially it's 30% off if I decide now to sign in or up if I'm a new user. And this is exactly what I did. So mobile app, but this time member rates and further undercut rates, 4,624 bahts. This is going to be the cheapest price that I'm going to see. Now, let's go to the very end of the booking process because I want to see what the final price is after taxes. So 10,883. All right. So this is the bottom price. Now, of course, I want to check the same price through the booking engine. All right. So direct price. What that is going to be. You see, same dates, two dots. And I just made up the screenshots, but you see the point. Same room, member rate. By the way, this is a member rate because I decided to sign up for the member rate in order to compare apples with apples, member rate through trip.com, member rate through the loyalty program that this hotel has been offering through their booking engine. But the bottom price still is higher. So essentially 700 bahts more expensive. And by the way, comparison could be more or less, I guess, around 20 euros, 20, 22 euros, more or less difference, which is not that much, but anyway, it's quite something. But besides, three different searches, or well, the exact same search, but with three different conditions, three different prices, and the final price is exactly where Ctrip wanted me, user, to end up to. Now, as we saw before, I made this search because the report was telling me that this hotel was underperforming with booking window 6 up to 10 days, and that's exactly what I did, what I wanted to check. Now, the report was also saying that this hotel was instead well performing with booking window 1 to 5, and this is exactly the second search that I made. So this time I make a search by selecting an arrival date which is less than 5 days ahead, and this is the initial result, but I'm following the exact same process. So the very first search on the mobile site, the call to action on top of Ctrip telling me to download the app so that I can get and benefit from better deals, and this is exactly what I did in the second place. And by the way, before that I deleted the app. Alright, because I wanted to delete any historical data, any previous search that I made even for the app. And the only way to do that is by deleting the app and then reinstall it. And this is the screenshot that I got after making the search and after having reinstalled the app. But besides the different values, you see that the process is exactly the same. Alright, so mobile site, then mobile app, CTA, so call to action 30% off if I sign up. And this is exactly again what I did, the third search, but this time, no cheaper deal. So you see the second screenshot and the third screenshot have the same deal. I'm not sure whether you have noticed, but this time the room is different. Now, Crystal Club Deluxe room is a different room. So I assume that the previous room, that the room that I selected in the previous search with different dates, which was the Deluxe room, was not available, but that's actually not true. It's simply Ctrip that now is offering me a higher room category instead of the previous room category that now is totally overpriced. But it's not not available, it is available, it's just a different revenue strategy, let's put it this way, from Ctrip offering me a sort of upsell at a cheaper deal. As a matter of fact, this is gonna be the final price for this room, Crystal Club Deluxe room, via Ctrip as a member rate. Let's see the booking engine. 13,586. As a matter of fact, the booking engine is cheaper, it's still cheaper than any member rate Ctrip is being offering to their customers. Alright, so that's why, at least one of the reasons why, booking window 1 up to 5 is still really well performing as opposed to booking window 6 up to 10. Alright, this was Ctrip. Now let's make another tentative, this time by looking into Expedia. So we start again from scratch, booking window 6 to 10, this time on Expedia. Now, Expedia mobile site, this is the price. Expedia mobile app, this is the price. SceneAccess booking engine, this is the price. Alright, you see the point anyway, the booking engine is higher. No matter whether it is the mobile site or no matter whether it is a mobile application, when it comes to booking window 6 up to 10, the booking engine is anyway higher. Anyway, that is something weird, of course, because Expedia mobile site and Expedia mobile app aren't supposed to be offering different deals, but this is of course a part of the Expedia way of dealing with their Expedia collect rate, and they do that very often. Now, comparing apples with apple, Expedia doesn't force people to sign up or to sign in for better deals. I selected a public rate. So comparing apples with apples, because again, Expedia is not asking me to sign up or sign in, and therefore I didn't select any member rate on the booking engine. And yes, anyway, the booking engine is higher. Booking window 6 to 10 underperforming. This is one of the reasons why. But again, same as we did before, booking window 1 up to 5 because it's well performing. Same process, Expedia mobile site, €520. Now this time, by the way, I'm looking at prices in euros simply because I have downloaded the application of Expedia through the German Apple Store. And that's why, first of all, you see some labels popping up in German and prices are automatically applied in euros. But anyway, €520 mobile site. Expedia mobile app, €468. Again, something different, something that I shouldn't expect to be seeing. And finally, the booking engine, but this time though, a little bit cheaper. So even though Expedia is undercutting the rates of this hotel, the booking engine remains cheaper. And this is one of the reasons why this hotel is anyway well performing when it comes to booking window 1 to 5. We detected the problem. Thanks to the data, we detected the problem. But of course, now we need to know how to fix it, how to find a solution. The solution is neither easy nor difficult. It's just a diplomatic way of dealing with these kind of things, in the sense that technically speaking, there is nothing that you need to do. However, the only thing that you need to do is just to prove it. And once you have proofs, like in this case, screenshots, you can share with your market manager at Expedia, Ctrip, or whatsoever, because what these guys are doing, illegal, immoral, I'm not saying it, your call, but anyway, they are not allowed to be doing so. So prove it, send them on to them, and let's see what they're gonna answer, because what I used to get is gonna be very fun, but I want you to discover that, and I'm not gonna tell you now what I got back. But this is the solution. So just prove it, again, collect proofs of it, send them on to your market managers, and let's just wait for them. If they don't reply, which by the way is something that is going to happen, so most of the times they are not going to reply, or they're going to take a little bit of time, but eventually just keep following up a little bit until you get a reply. And once you get a reply, eventually just share with me, because I'm going to be very curious about what you're going to get in terms of feedback, because I went through it already multiple times and it's going to be kind of hilarious. But I just leave you with a surprise. Just let me know, and again, we're going to see you with the next video. Bye-bye.